The AudioThing MiniVerb is an 8-bit delay echo plugin which emulates the typical 8-bit delay you can hear in, for instance, the Nintendo NES and Super NES consoles. I'll show you 3 ways how you can use this unique plugin to beef up your mixes. Hi, I'm Marlon and welcome to the White Noise Studio. Make sure you subscribe and hit the notification bell so you won't miss out on any new video. Okay, let's start out with a quick overview of the controls so you know what does what. The MiniVerb has a pre and post effect filter section with cutoff and resonance. Both of these can be set to either high or low pass. In the middle is the echo section where you set the delay. It can be set to milliseconds or it can be synced to the project. The echo can be switched to a double delay line here for a wider stereo image. Speaking about stereo image, you can set the width with this knob. And the feedback sets how often it delays. Unfortunately, no self-oscillation possibilities on this feedback. There's an unsyncable vibrator with the rate and depth, so you set it in hertz only. This is the crush section with a bit crush, a downsampler and a pitch shifter. Here are the dry and wet controls. You can set them independently. Now you know what does what, and I will show you some less obvious ways to show what this plugin can do to improve your mixes. 1. Because this plugin has a dry wet control, the bit crusher and a filter section, you can use it to enhance signals. Let me demonstrate with this snare. It's already on the snare, and what I've done is this. The pre-filter, echo and vibrato are off. With bits you can set the length and tone of the added signal. You can see that here in this frequency graph. This whole area is added just because of the bit crush section. And use the post-filter to fine-tune the sound. Let's add the dry signal back in, and this is with and without. It adds a bit of a metallic enhancement, which sounds nice in this already dirty loop. And if I add it to this kick, it generates a really fierce sounding attack. Ideal for certain types of metal. 2. Here is how you can use it to thicken and widen sound. And I use this on this synth lead. I'll use the echo synced to the tempo and in 8th dotted notes because this lead has that 4:3 rhythm. I dialed in a little bit of feedback and set the stereo to its widest. The crusher is used to dirty up the sound, but because I don't want a metallic vibe, I used the post filter section to low pass the delay. I set the resonance to 0 and I lowered the cutoff until it sounded right around 3.9 kHz. This is with and this is without the plugin. The delay needs to catch up, but when it's on it makes the lead sound thicker. You can do this too without a synced delay. Just set the delay time to 0 and tweak a bit more with the filters, feedback and dry wet controls to have it sound right. 3. If you want to create suspension or a build-up into a next section, you can do that very easily by precisely automating the dry wet controls, the pitch shifter and the bit crush section bypass. It will sound like this. Pretty neat, right? So other than using the MiniVerb as a standard delay, you can use this plugin in a useful and creative way to beef up your mixes. The MiniVerb is a great companion to the AudioThing MiniBit synth. Check my review here. Because it has a great sound and is really cheap, I would recommend you check it out and even add it to your plugin collection. Please remember to subscribe to this channel and like this video. Thank you for watching, and I'll see you in the next one. Bye!